Of course, I look forward very much to getting to the property and getting the hell out of the city. The city life is one of those necessary evils that anybody in my business has to put up with in order to be able to get these properties financed. And of course, there always has to be a certain amount of administration carried on. And as president of the company, I'm in charge of that administration. The Rheingold mine, of course, is located 225 miles west of Sudbury in what they call the Missinabe Forest Reserve, or Game Preserve, more properly. We take Transair at the number one air terminal, and from there we go to or fly to Sault Ste. Marie. From Sault Ste. Marie, we will take a DC-3 to Wawa, and from Wawa we will be able to get a taxi to the property only about 80 miles from Wawa.
We remind you to extinguish all smoking material at this time.
Flight number 743, departure gate number 49. Latest check-in time there is 8:30.
Okay, that's
have a pleasant flight.
Thank you very much.
Take care. Bye now.
My particular purpose, of course, in the trip is one of inspection to supervise the investment in the property and its progress at this particular time. It is due to come into production in about 2 weeks' time. And I want to make this personal visit to see that everything that needs to be done is being done in time for the opening of the mine. At this particular stage, of course, there has been $4 million invested in the operation, and a great deal of this has been by banking arrangements and very close supervision of all expenditures as required. I feel I've probably had as much operating experience in gold mines as any person has in Canada. Most people may think I've confined my efforts to prospecting, but in actual fact, I had around 20 years of operating, almost all of that in gold mines.
One of the things that I have felt throughout my whole lifetime is preserving my own independence. And I think that independence of mind, of occupation, I have never yet in my entire life worked for anybody else, aside from doing a consulting job or some such thing, and I still worked independently on it. Otherwise, I value my independence of being able to work and do the things I want to do. Well, I have tried to quit a number of times. As far as work is concerned, that is, if I didn't quit, I just wanted to do the more simpler things, and you'd say, well, why don't you just go and prospect now that you are independent and able to do it? And this I have done, but each time I've gone prospected, I've found something. Then I've had to turn around and try and develop the damn thing.
Sir? Weather in Wawa dictates that we should get going as quickly as possible.
All right.
It's been down, it's improved now, so go right on board.
Okay.
I want you to, Graham, we want to have our dinner ready by the time we get up there, eh?
No, I gotta get into the bank.
My name is Murray Watts. I'm 66 years old now. I would regard my occupation as first as a prospector, and secondly as a mining engineer or even a geologist. My life, of course, has been spent in Northern Ontario, following up that type of work, and especially in the Arctic. I regard myself as having spent about 45 years in our Canadian Arctic, and I think I can truthfully say that I have covered more of the North Country than any other human being in Canadian history. I was born in Cobalt and, of course, attended first public school in Cobalt and then high school and the Haileybury School of Mines in Haileybury, Ontario, which of course is only 5 miles away. I grew up in its early stages when Cobalt was, you might say, its most active. It was regarded as the richest silver area and the richest silver producer in the world. It was also known as a poor man's camp because you could go out without any funds at all and reap your fortune. We're getting away from the city. We're getting into the real world. Not the world of bureaucracy with all its artificialities and government problems and one thing or another. There's a tremendous relief. And I personally feel a completely new man. I feel like a free person. I feel free again. But I can answer it perhaps a little bit more superficially by saying this. The Honorable Arthur Lang, when he was Minister of Northern Affairs, once asked me, where did I think the best Eskimos were located? And my reply, which I think was quite adequate, was that any place where the government haven't got to yet. And that's the way I feel about it.